You're watching the Clewiston High School football team getting into a brawl. So the team was fighting with Inlet High School during their game last Friday, leading to the entire Clewiston team being suspended. It's a story we first broke to you yesterday on ABC 7. Thanks so much for joining us tonight at 6. I'm Megan Miller.
And I'm Jeff Harris. Referees were forced to end the game, which was only in the third quarter. Now, last night on your ABC 7 News at 7, we told you Clewiston's football team had been suspended, but we didn't know why. Tonight, not only do we have this brand new video, but we're also speaking to parents who were there when the punching started.
Oh, Jesus!
Right now at 6, ABC 7's Trent Bennett is sitting down with the parents you hear in that video, getting you more on what happened and what this means for the rest of the season.
Well, the Tigers should be playing on their practice field today, getting ready for their next game and for homecoming next week. But that's not the case. And a lot of people have already seen on social media that brawl that caused this team to be suspended indefinitely. And if you haven't, I spoke to the woman who was holding her iPhone, videoing it all as it played out. Take a look.
Oh, I go to every game. I'm at every game, and I'm live at every game. I haven't missed a game.
And thank goodness Jackie Young had her iPhone camera rolling when this happened.
Lord Jesus! Jesus!
It's the third quarter. The Clewiston Tigers just scored a touchdown against Inlet Grove. The score is 27-13. But Young says Inlet Grove's players and coaches were looking to settle the score with a fist fight.
All I saw was fear. I was so afraid for everybody on that field.
Once the fighting looks to have come to an end, another round of punches start flying.
After that, it just went berserk. And I was crying, Jesus, Jesus.
Viva Robinson was also in the stands. She's the one you hear yelling in the video. She says she was worried the worst was about to happen.
You know, Lord Jesus, please don't let nobody pull a gun.
Both teams have been suspended by the Florida High School Athletic Association indefinitely.
I've never been that afraid in my life.
The Tigers' last district game, scheduled for this Friday, is in limbo, as is next week's final game, which is also homecoming.
And the only thing they did when they left the sideline to defend themselves and their teammates. That's all they did. That's it.
Let's get away from here. Let's go. Let's get away from here.
Young is hoping the commission, who has the team's future in its hands, will just let the teams finish the season, despite the brawl that cleared the benches and the bleachers.
I spoke to the school superintendent, Mike Swindle. He tells me that all of the players, all of the coaches, all of the athletic trainers that were involved in this fight will be coached and trained going forward to deal with an issue like this should it ever happen again. He also tells me that he wants everyone to rest assured that because the football game next week for homecoming is in jeopardy, that doesn't mean that all of the homecoming events are canceled. They will still be scheduled as everybody has been preparing for, because football is a big deal here. For now, I'm reporting in Clewiston, Trent Bennett, ABC 7.
And throughout the